I know it's taboo, but we're gonna have to talk toilets to address a problem happening in Iowa City. Flushable wipes, personable wipes, intimate cleansing cloths, call them what you like. To Tim Wilkie, they're a pain in the butt.
Just remember, anything you flush down the toilet ends up at the wastewater treatment plant.
I know what you're thinking. It says flushable right on the box. Well, they do go down the toilet. But that's where the trouble begins.
Flushable wipes, a lot of times, are bonded by synthetic agents, typically polyesters. This polyester fiber does not break down in the sewers.
These synthetic, plastic-based products don't break down the same way as an organic material, such as toilet paper. Let's head to the lab to learn more. For this experiment, we will put three of the leading brands of flushable wipes, as well as toilet paper, into bins of water to see how they disintegrate. We'll let the magnetic stir sticks do their thing and we'll check back in a bit. The city attempts to catch unwanted materials that come through the sewer during a couple of different steps. Before we get too far, I should warn viewers that images from here on out may get, well, gross.
It's a dirty job.
The first line of defense are the 17 lift stations spread out across the city. These use large baskets to collect materials that flow through the 300 miles of sanitary sewer pipes in Iowa City.
What the basket does, it collects floatable material that's in the waste stream coming from the sewer system that would not necessarily be biodegradable within the treatment plant.
Twice a week, these baskets are emptied in an effort to keep items like wipes from causing problems.
If it's allowed to go downstream, it has the potential to cause blockages in the collection system itself and could plug up the pumps as well.
And that could lead to backups in your home, which nobody wants.
Ew, yuck.
Let's all take a moment to thank Josh for his work. But it doesn't stop there.
We don't always catch everything in the basket.
What fails to get gathered at the fill station flows here, the city's wastewater treatment plant. Nearly 10 million gallons of wastewater is processed here each day. The water is run through a screen that is designed to capture the remaining solid materials.
Floatable materials gets caught on the screen. Then we have a rake that comes down on a track system, comes down and grabs some material, pulls it up the top, and then dumps it into a hopper.
I wonder what the most common material collected is.
I'd say the bulk of it is flushable wipes.
At this point, you might be saying, so what? That's what the wastewater treatment plant is for. The problem is, you and I are the ones footing the bill.
There's increased maintenance costs because of the flushable wipes. That is tax dollars.
Not only does that mean more work to be done by the employees at the treatment plant, but costly breakdowns can also occur.
If it gets through the screens and gets into the system, there is opportunity for it to get into a pump. Then the pump can overheat, causing damage to the bearings and to the pump itself.
Let's go back to the lab for the results of our experiment. After an hour in water, the toilet paper is completely diluted. The flushable wipes, on the other hand, are either still in big chunks or entirely intact. So remember, just because they go down, doesn't mean they break down.
They just don't break down as they're advertised. Yeah, you can flush them down the toilet, but they usually end up in a basket, usually end up at the treatment plant, where we end up having to screen them out.
So if you can't give up your flushable wipes, toss them in the trash to save us a lot of trouble and tax dollars. And there's no buts about it. Sticking with the organic stuff is the best option.
As it is, toilet paper is the only material which will flush and will break down in the collection system.
Well, yeah, no shit.